thinks he'll be back in. Three fouls and all. As George Raveling has got to find somebody who can contain Murray a little bit.
Derek Martin is so quick. He's just creating opportunities. When he drives to the basket, you got to defend him because he can score. But if you're on the offensive team like Tracy Murray, keep your hands ready. Otherwise, he'll hit you right in the face. A tremendous pass back to back.
Banks is in along with Pat now, along with Monk and Coleman and Miner for the Bruins. Tracy Murray, Derek Martin, McLean, Wilson, and Matkins.
Again, Calvin Banks staying outside, and even Chris Monk on the wing to create opportunities for Harold Miner, who's held away from the ball by Gerald Matkins.
Matkins picks up only his second foul. For the Bruins, it's going to be two team fouls in this half. Back to inbound the ball. USC leads by three. Pass to Miner, poked away, and then with the ball, stepping over the sideline with it, was Matkins.
Well, he's working hard to bother Harold Miner, but Harold has got so much composure and ability, and so much of SC's offense is geared towards a very, very difficult challenge. Titan through a million picks tonight.
Only Trevor Wilson and Walker, and that's a considerable only, are seniors on the floor for UCLA. McLean, a sophomore. Matkins. Martin. Oh, there's some talent out there. Murray, a freshman.
Dan Mason, who we saw in the first half.
Yeah.
Mitchell Butler.
For three. Here comes Matkins and the Bruins. Bounce pass underneath. Wilson drives for two.
Nice play with his left hand. He turned on Greeley, scored out of the offense, and this time showing you he can run the court.
9 points for Wilson. He's gotten four here in this second half. The Trojan lead is down to one at 55-54, 13 and minutes and 48 seconds left to go. We'll be back after this.
If you feel life's more interesting when you make a splash,
it's the right beer now.
If you feel a great beer starts with great water,
it's the right beer now.
Because you're the kind of person who likes to get to the bottom of things, call for the silver bullet, the one that won't slow you down.
Coors Light, it's the right beer now.
Hey, Tony Granato, tired of digging your way out of all the snow in New York? You're gonna love Los Angeles. Thomas Anstrom, sick of all that Manhattan Midtown traffic? You're gonna love it with the King. To the two new Kings, from your newest friends at Prime Ticket. Welcome to L.A. USC Basketball is brought to you by your Southern California Chevrolet and Geo dealer. Now get a $1,250 factory cash rebate on a new 1990 S10 Blazer, two or four-wheel drive. See your dealer for details. Also by Coors, brewery fresh, pure and natural. It's a true American original. I mentioned earlier in passing that I thought these two guys at the bottom of your screen, Wilson and McLean, are the two best forwards on a college basketball team in the country. Now, I've not seen every pair of forwards, but I tell you, these will do as far as I'm concerned. And look at how they rank with the great ones, Wicks and Rowe, Johnson and Washington, Johnson and Greenwood. Boy, those numbers are very comparable. 39 points, 17 boards. There's Trevor Wilson. And I tell you, Trevor Wilson is tough. In addition to being talented, this is a tough ball player.
Led the Pac-10 in rebounding last couple of years. Very, very physical and strong.
SC shooting 75% in the second half on 6 of 8. Thank you, Jim. And the Bruins shooting 63%. Has the pace been torrid? Indeed it has. Miner with it. Back out to Banks. Over to Pack. Coleman, double team. Baseline, short. Monk tips. No. Working hard, but case of love's labor lost. Up the floor, Monk. Boy, they're really giving the ball to Wilson. Over the rim. McLean over the rim. Wilson above the rim. Whistle. Hold everything. Foul underneath. Will be against the Trojans. Now, when I told you Trevor Wilson was tough, that's a perfect example of what I mean. This guy plays above the rim on the miss. Watch, he'll get that ball again.
Good offensive action on the glass. Don McLean first there. Great pair of forwards. Trevor Wilson, as you mentioned, he's tough, hard-nosed, took a terrific fall in the first half. Here he is out here still banging.
Bad pass, and Coleman picks it up. Coleman comes out of the backcourt with it.
Without goggles again.
Yes. It's a sometimes thing, Ronnie. Pack brings it up the floor. Coleman picked up a foul a moment ago. Miner. Right side to Pack. Back out to Banks. Banks gives the ball to Pack. Boy, I tell you, don't be too cavalier with that basketball, because Matkins and Martin will just steal it away like a thief in the night. They have got some great hands. Now, that's not a very good pass by Banks. Gets it back, drives, shoots, misses. Rebound comes to McLean, and here come the Bruins. 4-on-2. Traveling. Well, that's one of the few times Martin will make a mistake handling that ball in the middle.
Boy, he's made some great assists. A rare mistake from Derek Martin in the middle. Talking about thieves in the night, I asked Jim Herrick about Derek Martin. He said, that young man is a thief of Baghdad.
Boy, he's got some hands on him, hasn't he? All right, up the floor, Robert Pack. His 7 points to start the second half ignited a Trojan rally that saw them wipe out a six-point deficit, take a lead, Pack short with that little 10-footer. Ball knocked away, but nobody goes after it but Martin. Wilson. Martin. On rebound to Pack. 2-on-2. Pack in the middle. And a foul is going to be called. It'll be on Matkins. And that'll be his third.
What hard contact at the free throw line. Robert Pack driving the ball up the court. Really means business here. Changes direction and just runs into Gerald Matkins. And he looked like he might have been set. A little an awkward play.
Really was. Into the ball game comes Chapman going out as Pack. The officials for a moment, Tommy Harrington had his hand up, and I think he just quivered for a moment as to who he was going to point to.
Very unusual position for contact.
Underneath, Monk fakes, puts it up, gets it, and he's fouled. Well, that's hard work by Christian Monk. That's his 8th point of the evening.
Chris Monk is strong, and when he gets the ball near the basket, he doesn't take it quickly. He's got to carve out some turf here. He's just a pile driver inside, and Tracy Murray gets him over the top.
Trojans lead 57-54. Their advantage back up to 3 now. It has been at its biggest, 5. Coming into the game is Walker. Coming in is Butler. Matkins is getting a breather. Murray's getting a breather.
Jim Herrick again using all the depth he's got over there on that bench. Every time he looks to his left, lots of talent.
Chris Monk, second in the Pac-10, 86% at the line. Miner gets the rebound, tries to put it up, he gets it, and he is fouled.
Boy, that's not baby Jordan, that's grown-up Jordan, getting 5 from all the fellas over on the bench. That is an NBA play right here and now for the freshman.
Walker picks up the foul.
Watch this. Not only does he get a tough rebound, he's up there. He's hanging. Draws the contact from Walker. Shoots the ball almost back on the ground. Tremendous play.
Looking to make it a 3-point effort. He has the Trojans on top by 5 at 59-54. 60-54. 20 points for Miner. He had 14 at the intermission. George Raveling wants the crowd up. Get him involved. Can't blame him. Been a long time between sips for the Trojan coach.
SC's playing a lot of man-to-man defense. UCLA trying to create some mismatches. I wouldn't be surprised if he goes to the zone later on in the half.
Martin walks back toward the midcourt area. 22 on the shot clock. Butler to Wilson. Bruins. They bring it down the floor for the rush. Martin to the baseline. Beautiful move.
in that zone defense don't want to give Miner the opportunity to create on his own and take it all the way to the basket.
Miner for three. Short. Rebound pulled down by McClain. Up the floor to Martin at midcourt. Bruins don't give you time to get back and get set. There's a turnaround by Wilson. He's got 11.
Boy, is he strong inside. UCLA fans drove down here to the sports arena. Look at his upper body, and he uses it all right here. And again, Derek Martin is doing a great job distributing the basketball.
And this foul is on Miner.
Drills it off the glass, and Trevor Wilson knows that was a very big basket.
Big East Conference this year doesn't kick you out of the game when you get 5 fouls.
They let you have another one. I think that's sending a false message. They're saying they play so physical back there that they need an extra foul. But I'll tell you, there's physical basketball played all over the United States, including right here.
Wilson can't make free throw. And McClain
tried to pop the basketball.
McClain was really upset. The free throw line, Wilson is 1 of 5.
SC needs something out of their zone offense. They have not been able to penetrate this defense of UCLA.
60 to 58. 10 minutes remain. Miner.
I think Miner needs a little bit of a rest if George Ravlin can afford to get him out just for a minute or two. A couple of tired shots, but he drilled this one.
You can't afford to take him out of the game. He's got 25. 63. 58.
Yeah, he's not sitting down the rest of the way.
Wilson in the middle, turns, and Greeley's going to pick up the foul.
This is just too much for Greeley, the freshman, to handle. Chris Monk coming back in the ballgame.
Well, let me tell you, I don't know where this ballgame would be if the Trojan bench was giving the starters any help. Chapman has played, Greeley has played, Fuller has played, Carter has played, though briefly. None have scored a point. Not a point. Contrast that with Butler getting 4, Walker 2, Mason 2.
And giving the starters lots of very valuable rest.
Can you believe that this guy can't shoot free throws? I can't believe it. Oh. Well, he's 1 for 6. I tell you, you know, he's all conference. I mean, this guy can play. But he, for some strange reason, all alone, uncontested, line just murders this guy.
He's just strung tight as a drum, and he's not relaxed up at the line at all.
63-58 Trojan up the floor, Pack with the ball.
Have to wonder how this Trojan basketball team is 1-8 in the Pac-10, because they do have some talent out there.
Well, under George Raveling, they have lost 30 games in the last 3 years, Paul Sunderland. Average of 6 points per ball game. Yep. 30 games.
Recently, 2 Oregon here in the sports arena by 1.
Coleman, tip by Monk, no. Tip again, no. And a foul on Monk underneath. He's got 3. Well, Oregon has beaten them the last 3 times on last second tip-ins.
Boy, this ball hangs around the basket for a long time. Ronnie Coleman puts it up there with no spin, and they're just battling here on the boards. The referees are letting them play. But once Don McClain had the ball with both hands, he got hammered hard by Coleman or Monk.
Well, now McClain is a different sort of cat at that free throw line. We're looking at 86% now. Bruins trail by 5. He's got 10 points now.
His technique is so good at the free throw line. And Jim Herrick, I talked to him before the game, and he seemed very relaxed and confident, but the Trojans are putting all kinds of pressure on him right now.
Wayne is really working the boards. Well, even he was 63-59. Oh, pass, badly thrown. Trojans turn it over, up the floor. Martin on the break, scores it, and a foul on Pack.
Boy, talk about complicating a tough mistake. Throw the ball away at midcourt, and then one point guard challenging the other. Derek Martin clearly getting the better of it. Score the hoop and go to the line.
Well, it's compounding a felony. First he throws the ball away, and then Martin's drive to the bucket, Pat fouls.
Boy, you're not going to get that call. He was there so late trying to draw the charge. line is playing right into USC's hands.
SC leads now by two at 63-61.
And UCLA goes back to the man-to-man, surprisingly, after having so much success in the zone, Mitchell Butler holding Harold Miner inside.
So Butler picks up the foul. That is his third, the sixth team foul. Harold Miner in the ball game tonight.
Since he left the game with that shoulder injury,
he's still flexing that right arm as though it's in pain.
It's a chronic problem. I asked one of the trainers during a timeout what was wrong with his shoulder. It's a chronic weakness in that shoulder, really causing him problems when he passes the ball.
Chapman is about to come in the ball game for him.
Down to 10 on the 45-second clock.
Banks at the baseline, short, rebound underneath, foul will be called. Coleman missed the putback, and the foul will be on Walker.
Time was going down on the clock. Outside shot from Banks. Doesn't want to take it from there. Maybe partially deflected. UCLA was lucky in the first half. Ronnie Coleman lucky, but not completely. Should have put that one back in the hole. Would have been a big basket.
Tracy Murray is back in.
Robert Pack had to leave the ballgame again because of that shoulder.
Might have accounted for that rather cavalier pass that he flipped up a moment ago that was intercepted, resulted in two and a foul. Coleman, goggles on his forehead. He's got a total now of 15 points in the ballgame. At 10 at halftime. Trojans have not gotten a point off the bench. 64-61, SC by three. Their biggest advantage has been five. They were down by six at the intermission. Out of the corner, McClain. Rim rattler won't go, and Chapman has the rebound. 7:52 remaining in the ballgame. A year ago here at the Sports Arena, where the Bruins won it, Lou Richardson with a last-second jump shot with about 20 to go. Miner. Here come the Bruins. 3-on-2. McClain pulls up, misses, rebound Monk. And he drops it out of bounds. Trojans had about 20 seconds left in the game a year ago here, Paul. Didn't even call a timeout. And put up a shot that was about 40 feet from the basket when it went up and was about 8 feet from the basket when it came down.
Yeah.
Losing by a point, Lou Richardson. So there have been some heartbreaking losses for Rattling and the Trojans. Not only against UCLA, but in the conference. Underneath, Coleman takes the ball away, and a foul is going to be called. Have to check and see who it's on. Harrington will tell us. Might be Wilson. It's going to be on Trevor Wilson.
Both teams in the bonus now. Robert Pack coming back in the ballgame. Let's hope he's all right. Ronnie Coleman blocked the shot of Mitchell Butler first and then scraps for the rebound. Looked like Trevor Wilson got him on the wrist.
He did, and that is only the first foul on Wilson. Here's Coleman at the line. Made one of two a moment ago. Missing. Miner can't get the rebound, or can he? Pulls it down. Possession. Ball goes to SC.
Boy, that's great work by the freshman. Ronnie Coleman got to make these free throws. Lots of time to play. All of them important, particularly in the one-and-one. Jim Herrick got to be upset letting that freshman guard in there, challenging his big guys for that rebound.
Miner gets a breather. He's out with 7:22 to go in the ball game. SC leading by three. Robert Pack at the baseline to inbound the ball. 45 on the shot clock. Tension, 10 cents a ton. Underneath to Coleman. Big guy horses it up, puts it in. He's got 17.
He lost a lot of weight going into this season and hasn't speeded him up, and he still is strong.
Well, the Bruins want a timeout. 7:11, time remaining. Trojans lead by 5 points, and the Sports Arena is alive. We'll be back after this. Excitement that is USC Athletics with Prime Tickets, USC Sports Magazine. Catch it Thursdays at 6 on Prime Ticket, the world's largest regional sports network. Well, the hectic night here at the sports arena around the conference. Gary Payton, who I think is the best point guard in the nation, 26-6. McLean at 24. Keefe of Stanford, what a fine player. Miner, Trevor Wilson. Now, that's a pretty nice group right there. You know, you could take those five and
not a bad
challenge a lot of people.
Team.
Tell you, would you like to have Payton and Miner in the backcourt, huh? The rivalry. Six of the last 13 meetings have been decided by 5 points or less. Last year, as a case in point, 1 point. Decided it for the Bruins and their brilliant playmaking guard, Pooh Richardson. Jimmy Herring.
Not a happy camper going into that last timeout. Very disappointed, I think, that his team is not in good offensive flow. McLean nor Wilson have been getting too many shots in the last 5 minutes near the basket. Tracy Murray not been a factor in the second half.
Miner will be in when the ball is dead. Let's see, leads by five. Wilson with 18 on the shot clock. Works his way in small measures. Little hippity hop steps into the lane. He's got 13. Pass up the floor. Saved by Chapman. To Pack. 66-63. SC's lead is three. They've been ahead by five on several occasions, all in the second half. Trailed by six at the intermission. Pack with the ball. Bruins in a 1-1. Ball knocked into the backcourt. Trojans will get it. 26 on the shot clock. Will they give us another 45? Let's see what the guy wants to do. There's Harold Miner coming in. Miner with 25, and Murray's got 19. We told you about these two freshmen. In the game over at Pauley, Miner had 15, and Murray had 3. Good, so their game has picked up a little bit.
Has indeed, and good substitution by George Raveling. Got his young freshman just enough rest to make him very strong going down the stretch with just over 6 minutes to play.
Seven on the shot clock. Pack with three. Jump shot in the air. No. Rebound comes off. Foul is called on McLean for pushing off. That is only his first foul. Consider that this big guy, the last time I looked, our producer pumped up a stat there. He had something like 14 boards.
14 rebounds. He's not been hanging around tonight. He's been working very, very hard.
And only one foul.
And only one foul. Well, he's only been caught once.
I tell you, he is a... Well, I think I've kind of worn it to death. There's some awfully good talent on the floor out there. And a lot of it is wearing blue and blue on such a young basketball team. Misses, tip is up and good by Banks.
Twice in a row, the Trojans have beaten the Bruins when they've had inside position on the free throw line.
Another 5-point lead for SC with 5:47 to go in this ball game. Coleman gets knocked down. Wilson goes down with him. The clash of bodies.
The contact in there, most of it inadvertent. Chris Monk, they're just getting wrapped up in there. I guess you got to call something. But Chris Monk is doing a pretty good job of making Trevor Wilson, although he certainly doesn't like it, catch the ball farther and farther from the basket.
Chris Monk gets the foul. Now, let me tell you, years ago there was a comic by the name of Frank Fontaine whose standard reply was, I wasn't doing nothing, I was just standing around. That's what Monk was doing, standing there, and bodies were flying everywhere, and they hit him with the foul.
Might not turn out too badly for USC, given the way Trevor Wilson shoots free throws.
Can't make him miss them all. Trevor, way to go. So he got 14 points in the ball game now. Finally gets a free throw after so many misses. 68-64, SC leads. 68-65 as Wilson converts both of them.
Boy, those look sweet. Where were those earlier in the game?
There's a pass down the floor. Pack throws the ball to Miner. Miner wasn't even looking at him. Why would Pack? Well, Banks has it top of the key. Pack just outside three-point range to Miner in the corner, guarded by Matkins to Coleman. Back out to Pack to Banks. Turn around by Greeley. On the rim, no. Banks tips, no. Rebound to McLean. Trojan lead is three. They've led by five many times.
Got a double team. You got to help Greeley.
Foul is called on Greeley as Wilson went straight up over him. And for Greeley, his third.
Trojans are doing a nice job. Jim Herrick obviously knows that he's got a one-on-one situation anytime he wants it with Trevor Wilson. What USC's got to do is once they force Trevor out farther to catch the basketball, they got to run somebody else at him and double team, make him kick it to somebody outside.
Wilson has a total of 15 points in the game despite being only 3 of 9 at the free throw line. Make it 3 of 10.
Arena, they're up and screaming.
going to set up a new 45. There's George Raveling. 3-26 against the Bruins, career-wise. 0-7 here at the arena.
After another timeout, George Raveling's team, two each remaining for both teams, but after another timeout, George Raveling's team with possession came out and scored an easy basket. Can UCLA score out of their timeout?
They did reset the shot clock to 45. Under 2 minutes. Wilson. It back to McLean, blocked. Coleman blocked it, blocked again. Bodies are flying everywhere under there, and a foul will be called against the Trojans.
Boy, lots of conversation along the Bruins sidelines. One of the Trojans had his hand up in the hoop.
George Raveling is up. The officials are over telling Jim Herrick.
Watch here after the block. McLean goes again for the follow, and Monk has got his hand up inside the rim. Not a goaltending, but basket interference.
Called on Monk, and that is his fifth, and Monk will leave the game with 8 points. And now the officials are talking to both. That is Booker Turner, as Monk is going to foul out. Talking to both Jim Herrick of UCLA and George Raveling of USC. And I don't think we have to get involved with any comment or commentary about Herrick and the reprimand he received from the Pac-10 Congress.
Jim Herrick is a great competitor. I've known him for 20 years, and he has not mellowed with age. I think he's got a case there. One of the Trojan players, maybe Monk, was up there with his hand on the rim.
Five fouls on Monk. I think everybody at this end of the floor and everybody in the court knew it. Well, look at it again now. There's Monk, 45.
Hand wrapped right up around the rim just for a split second. Probably did not interfere with the play, but technically might have been goaltending.
8 points for Monk tonight. He had 10 in the previous meeting.
Well, they need to repeat that no one off the USC bench has scored this evening.
Greeley is in, replacing Monk. Greeley, Banks, go to the line. He's in there with Wilson and Murray and Matkins and Markham.
We've taken our sweet time talking about this particular play.
Let me tell you, these officials are getting control of this game. Here's McLean, 12 points, 19 rebounds tonight.
Well, that's
he's an 86% at the line.
A huge basketball game. Came down to free throws as I was driving down thinking about this. You think SC cannot win. Calvin Banks can certainly make a big contribution to prove me wrong if he sticks a couple free throws here. They're a poor free throw shooting team.
73-70.
Isn't
nothing.
This game something?
Nothing. Isn't this game? That's
but
the fifth point of the night for. Isn't this game something? I mean, is the rivalry alive? Are you kidding me? 74-70. I don't know who's going to win this, but I tell you, Banks is at the line trying to prove everybody wrong and makes still another.
And he just improved his Banks' foot first, but then off Calvin Banks out of bounds.
But it did go off Banks' foot and go out.
Yep.
His was the last to touch it. Well, there's the scenario. 75-72, SC by three. The Bruins will have the ball. We've got a minute to play. Don't go away. We'll be right back. The Trojans lead by three at 75-72. The Bruins have the ball. We're under a minute. Martin with it. To Wilson. Guarded by Banks.
Set play out of the timeout. Going to get the ball to Wilson or McClain.
In the corner. Back out. Matkin starts to drive all the way under. Misses. They'll have a foul called on SC.
Well, not the shot that Jim Herrick wanted, but Gerald Matkins. Good head and shoulder fake at the top of the key and took it strong to the hoop.
Foul is called on Harold Miner. It's his fourth. Matkins at the free throw line is a 65% free throw shooter.
Well, that young man hit a couple of huge free throws to keep the pressure on UCLA. See if Gerald Matkins can return the favor.
45 seconds remain in this basketball game. Matkins makes it a one-point game. 75-73, a two-point game. Matkins has 3 points in the ballgame now. Matkins again. Misses. Rebound. Greeley on the floor for it. Pulls it up. Holds it. Drops it. Stolen away. Shot is up and good by Wilson. The game is tied. 75-75. 34 seconds. Chapman to Miner. Goes under. Gets fouled. I mean deliberate. The Trojans are on the floor. Coming out. They're going to ask for two. He'll get two anyway. And I tell you, they're pulling McClain away from Greeley.
Boy, two men going to the basket. Don McClain and Keith Greeley, the freshman, really going at one another. George Raveling came
Tommy
off the
Harrington
bench
and
shot.
Sidoff are trying to get Raveling to calm down. George is upset. Miner's all right. He'll go to the line to shoot a pair. The game is tied at 75.
Just like in the NBA, there are no layups allowed down the stretch. He's trying to foul him. There's no doubt about it. He's not trying to hurt the man, but he was not going to let him attempt a three-point play. Boy, Harold Miner takes the ball to the basket strong, trying to hang like he did earlier on. Don McClain, again, I think with a good play on the basketball court, you can't allow layups.
Well, Harold Miner will go to the line to shoot a pair. He has 26 points tonight. The game is tied. There's 30 seconds left to go.
And Harold Miner is a good free throw shooter at nearly 80%. Oh boy, what a basketball game. Jim Herrick knows it. Calvin Banks back in the ballgame. If Harold Miner makes both these free throws, UCLA may call their last timeout to establish something at the offensive end.
Crowd is on its feet. Baby Jordan misses.
Gives UCLA a chance to win with their possession.
Makes the second. He's got 27 points. SC 76-75. 30 seconds. Martin over the timeline. Timeout. A year ago, in an almost similar situation, the Bruins, down by one, came back and had Boo Richardson with just a handful of seconds left on the clock hit a jumper to go ahead by one. And the Trojans, with about this much time left, came back down the floor and never got off a shot. And UCLA has won still another. Timeout left, Bruins none. The Trojans have two. SC has two timeouts left.
UCLA wants to do coming out of this, their last timeout, is run a set play. They'll kick it to, there's lots of time on the game clock, the 45. and let them create on their own. If they don't have anything, they'll try to rotate the ball back. If they get down inside the last 10 seconds, they'll spread the court for Derek Martin and let him penetrate the middle, take the shot in his own, or kick outside. Lots of possibilities with so many weapons on the court for UCLA. USC might play a zone defense and take them right out of that strategy.
Well, it'll be interesting to see what we will see. It has been a long time between sips for the Trojans in this series. That hasn't dimmed the intensity of this rivalry, though. And here they come. 1986 was the last time the Trojans defeated UCLA in this arena. 79-64. Last SC victory. They've lost seven times in the interim. 50 of the last 59.
Here's a thought for you. UCLA's in the bonus. As soon as Trevor Wilson catches the ball, you foul him, make him go to the free throw line and shoot the one and one.
Well, now you're at 22 seconds. 21. You'll see it in the bottom of the screen.
Here's the set play for Trevor Wilson. Good front denial by Greeley on the play.
A lot of people in blue up. Oh, steal by Coleman. Coleman holds it. He is fouled with 7.5 seconds. SC leads by one. Ronnie Coleman can make it a three-point game if he can make the free throw.
You're traveling, calling all the Trojans over. Ronnie Coleman is not a good free throw shooter.
Well, he hasn't been, 52%.
Greeley did a good job defensively. Right out here, that Ronnie Coleman helping. The plane throws the ball right to it. Would have been lucky if he could have kicked it to a better free throw shooter right
well,
there.
Well, had he made just a pass and gotten the ball in play and moving, why the 7 seconds, 7.5, could very easily have disappeared off the clock. So here they are, Coleman to the line. 7.5 seconds remain. He has made 1 out of 5 tonight and 52% on the year.
And let's remember, if UCLA misses, they have no timeouts, cannot stop the clock. They got to come right down and attack.
Coleman misses. The ball is grabbed by Wilson. 6 seconds. 6.4 seconds. Bruins can't call timeout. They don't have any timeouts left.
The call is off the free throw. Booker Turner called that the ball went over the backboard.
No!
And they will reset the clock to the second set.
Would make it 7.5. And the Trojans had better pick up everybody defensively and not stand around and look at one another.
This is the biggest break that UCLA could have gotten. This is virtually a timeout. Gives them a complete opportunity to get organized rather than just getting a rebound off
the
missed free throw.
They can inbound the ball anytime. There's been no timeout taken. The clock has not been changed. It's at 6.4.
UCLA with the basketball.
Murray will inbound the ball. 95 feet. If they ever get the clock and the game going. Now they've set it at 7.4.
That's what it was at.
It was 7.5, but who's going to argue?
Who's going to argue 110? When Ronnie Coleman went to the free throw line.
All right, the Bruins inbound the ball. Martin has it. 6-4. Mark over the timeline. 2-1-3. Wilson driving, pulls up, throws it up, it's over. The Trojans have won. The lamb has eaten the butcher. Can you believe it? 76-75 for George Raveling. The crowd is over. Raveling and the Trojans have turned in one of the major upsets in the Pac-10 this 1989-90 basketball season.
Biggest win in USC basketball in my memory, and a big win for George Raveling and his Trojans.
I haven't seen this much excitement at the sports arena in 5 years. 76-75 SC. We're going crazy here. The Trojans beat the Bruins. We'll be back. The final wrap-up right after this message.
This original painting of Larry Bird, basketball's American hero, created by Alan Hackney, and this finely detailed oil painting of Dwight Evans of the Boston Red Sox, portrayed by sports artist Armin LaMontagne, are both displayed at the New England Sports...
USC over UCLA in a major college upset. Not only in the Pac-10, but around the country, perhaps. The Bruins, highly regarded among the nation's top 20 ball clubs, and the Trojans prevailing. What a thrilling victory for the Trojans. No other way to put it. Down by six at the intermission, 44-38. Robert Pack set him off with seven straight points to open the second half. They went on top by five, and they never lost the lead. It was tied, but they never lost the lead. And even though Miner went to the free throw line with two precious free throws with virtually 20 seconds left, 7.5 seconds, I should say, and missed them both, the Trojans somehow still won the basketball game.
Well, first of all, what a tremendous college basketball game, and clearly the biggest upset in the Pac-10 this year. Tracy Murray goes for 15 in the first half, only 4 in the second. Harold Miner, the other super freshman, was tremendous throughout. And remember the free throws by Calvin Banks, our 25% free throw shooter. USC wins by one. One of those points clearly belongs to Calvin Banks.
We told you about the two freshmen. Well, Miner had 27, and the other for UCLA, Tracy Murray, had 19. The Trojans got...